remove duplicate amounts, but there's a twist. Today's question from Michelle. She wants to clear duplicate data from a column, but keep the rows and not delete or remove the rows. So she has something like this, like the company appears with multiple dates and the same amount in every cell. Michelle needs to keep the amount in the top cell, but clear the amounts in the other cells without removing those rows. So here's what I would do. I would insert a column here. I'll just call it check. And we'll say equal this name equal to the name above us. That's either going to generate true or false all the way down. And then we go to the data tab, turn on the filters, and under check, we want all of the trues. All right, so now that we have just the ones we want to clear, we can do Ctrl Shift Down Arrow and press the delete key. When we remove the filters, you see that we have the amount on just the first row. The other rows remain there with the other dates, and we can remove the check column. Now, a couple of things here. If your data is not sorted by company name, then we need to have a way to check to see if any of the cells above us, from A1 down to the cell right above us, is equal to the current value. And I'm doing that with the COUNTIF function. So we're gonna look from A$1, that says always start at the heading, to A1 without a dollar sign, the row right above the cell, is equal to the name in this cell. And now we generate zeros and ones, and all the things that are greater than zero are the ones we want to clear. So open the dropdown, unselect zero, leave everything else, and then clear these amounts. And I checked with Michelle, and she says that the company name, all of the amounts will always be the same. But what if there was some weird situation where, like, there were two different companies and some of them had a different amount here? Then you would want to change this formula to check for two things, to see if the company name is equal to the company name above and if the amount in C2 is equal to the amount above. And then that would keep both this version of 3M and that version of 3M. It's removed duplicates, but it's worth a twist. Thanks to Michelle for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.